In fact, the topic on which the panel discussion is going to take place is really very interesting, the founder's control and succession planning, which is viewed as one of the issues of debate when we talk about the corporate governance. And we have some elite panel members over here who would be expressing their views, and this entire session will be moderated by CA Shri Varnit Jainji. He is a partner at GK Mittal and Associates Jaipur, so he'll be the moderator. I have the pleasure of introducing before you Shri GP Madanji, who is Managing Partner, Madan Law Offices, Advocates and Solicitors, Vice President, Insolvency Practitioners Bar Association, Insolvency Profession. He is an alumnus of Shri Ram College of Commerce, Law Graduate from Campus Law Center, Fellow Member of ICSI, besides holding diplomas in Labor Laws and Corporate Laws and Management, and has vast practical experience of about 32 years in corporate, legal, secretarial, capital markets, financial and managerial disciplines. He is Managing Partner of Madan Law Offices, Advocates and Solicitors. The firm specializes into corporate legal advisory, arbitration and litigation. Sir, we are really honored that you have made it to Banasthali. A grand welcome to him. We also have with us CA Shri Varnit Jainji, as I mentioned. He is an accomplished chartered accountant with around 5 years experience in various big corporate organizations at regional corporate levels across the banking. Of course, now I think the experience is much more. Manufacturing, infrastructure, industries in India. He is proficient at creating value for organizations by driving competitive advantage through improving existing operations, driving cost advantage, and continuously suggesting the organization on updation of the internal circulars and processes. You'll be pleased to know that he has been the part of the audit and compliance team at Yes Bank, HDFC Bank, etc. So we are really honored, Varnit ji, that you have made it to the campus on our request. You all will be very happy to know that we have with us a CA, Ms. Sangeeta Bordia ji as well. She is mainly engaged in practice of direct taxes for more than 22 years in Udaipur, and of course in indirect taxes also. And she has represented clients at Income Tax Department, Service Tax Department independently. At present, she has co-opted member of Committee for Capacity Building of Members in Practice, the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India for the year 2018-19. She was elected as a chairperson of Udaipur branch of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India in 2010, nominated as chairperson of Udaipur Tax Bar Charitable Society. In 2003 to 2005, she also co-opted as director in Udaipur Mahila Urban Cooperative Bank, Udaipur. So ma'am, we are really honored that you have accepted our invitation. Finally, please also welcome Dr. Vikas Balia, who is founder of Legal Sphere Jodhpur. He has a team of 25 bright professionals keeping up the task and working on contracts, drafting, review, vetting, amendments, legal documentation, legal research, taxation, paralegal, etc. And it's really amazing that we have a galaxy of speakers here today. I welcome Dr. Vikas Balia as well. And now I request all the panel members to please grace the stage.
Namaskar. Good afternoon. I know it's very difficult after lunch. बहुत लोगों को नींद भी आती है और टॉपिक भी although interesting है and it becomes very much important in nowadays corporate scenario. The topic for today's discussion is founder control and succession planning. First, I would like to thank the management of Banasthali to invite us for such a wonderful conference, and would like to welcome Mr. Madan, Madan sir, well-known professional, Sangeeta madam, and Vikas sir. who have spared their time from their valuable schedule for today's topic. And without wasting much time, we'll start off with the topic. The topic assigned to us is founders' control and succession planning. The founder controls become very, very much important in the present scenario, and with the helping of, since the conference is about corporate governance, and the control of a promoter or the person managing the business to some extent unveil the corporate governance. Lot of issues have been there in the past across different corporates which are facing such difficulty. If the management should be very more professional, or what kind of interference of the promoter or the founders or the generation to comes of the founders should be there in the corporate environment. So I would like to ask to the panel member few some questions regarding key, just to guide us on the said topic. So my first question to the panel members is, what is the dynamics of difference in managing the business environment in India when it compares to other developed countries? For example, in USA, the dynamics of business and control of the founders are very much limited in the developed countries, but the same situation is not there in the developing country. So I would like Mr. Madan sir to please guide us on the said topic. What is the dynamics in the business environment in developing countries and developed companies in context to the topic? Sir, please.
If you're talking about the dynamics, I think dynamics in the rest of the world and India are absolutely different. In India, we are more family-driven businesses. It is barring certain companies like L&T and ACC. Other than almost all the companies, you will find that management, the companies are being controlled by families, their relatives, their own family members. And even though one of the top members is going out of the company, though they are not part of the board, but still they want to retain the remote control with them. And we have seen number of cases like that, and some in the recent past only, about a year or during last 1 year or so, we have seen particularly in case of Tata Group, in case of Infosys, in case of Raymond, we have seen a number of allegations have been leveled on those people who are not there on the board, who are out of the board, but the allegations have been leveled that they are controlling the businesses. They are giving the directions, and on their directions only the businesses are being run. You know, last year in the month of April, when Mr. Tyagi, new SEBI chairman, joined, what he simply said, that we need drastic changes in the corporate governance norms. Because in India, what he said, that independent directors are not independent. Audit committees are not functioning. Independent directors are just resigning from the board without any assigning any reasons. And the boards are being governed by certain individuals, and they just do not want to lose the control over the board, and there is no room for professionals in the functioning of the board. That is why he immediately suggested let there be a committee to be constituted to recommend to the government what sort of changes should be there in the listing regulations. He constituted a committee under the chairmanship of Mr. Uday Kotak. This committee gave its recommendations to SEBI, and all those recommendations were put before the public for their feedback. And ultimately in the month of October, the final report was there. And lately, as on April 2018, at least half of that report has been adopted by SEBI now. For rest half, they have rejected the proposals. Now we have very, very stringent regulations, particularly for listed companies. And we are expecting that we may have a better governance. But if you ask me individually, I normally say that these codifications, these laws, rules, regulations, guidelines, they just cannot bring governance in the companies. Governance has to come from the mindset only. You have n number of legislations, but you won't have governance unless you are determined to bring governance in the corporate sector. We have Indian Penal Code. where it is written that rape is punishable, where it is written that death is punishable. Do we see that reduction in the number of death cases? Do we see reduction in number of rape cases? Answer is no. No legislation can bring governance in here. It's only the mindset which can bring governance. And in my second round, if you want, I would like to discuss the Tata Mistry case also, if time allows and you permit me.
Definitely would like to know what was the main reason why Ratan Tata have to step in again and remove Cyrus Mistry from the post of the chairman of Tata. All that was a more of a controversial thing, but we would like to Mr. Madan to please elaborate the case. Before this, we just want a view of Sangeeta ma'am on the dynamics of business. What is the difference of the dynamics of business in India and USA? In USA, companies are more professionally managed. For example, if you take an example of Microsoft, in India, when we take example of big groups like Reliance or Tata, they are more family oriented. They have their independent board of directors, they have their independent directors, but still, if they are on the board, if they are not on the board, still the controls are in their hand. Is it very necessary for India, or we should think of some redrafting of policy? So I would like the opinion of Sangeeta ma'am on the same.
Varnit, aapne mujhse pucha ki India mein founders control, yani family business ki dynamics kya as compared to global. First of all, I want to share that in India, more than 60% business is governed by family business, which is India is the third largest country, jahan pe third generation business jo hai, wo family dwara run kiya ja raha hai. It's a very good